welcome back. Earlier this week we had our 10th and final Halloween Horror Nights announcement, and it is an exciting one. So our final house is Rob Zombie's House of a Thousand Corpses. Oh my god, I have been dying to see this house for the longest time. It's literally been on my Halloween Horror Nights dream list since it came out in 2003. This is one of my favourite films of all time, and it was featured over in Hollywood's event in 2010 and 2011. However, did you know that this film is actually based off of a Halloween Horror Nights house? So back in 2000, Halloween Horror Nights in Hollywood had asked Rob Zombie to help them to create a maze for that year's event, and he came up with House of a Thousand Corpses. During that same year, inspired by the house that he'd created for Halloween Horror Nights, he pitched an idea for a film. The filming was complete around Halloween time, and they'd decided to kind of tie the house and the film in together, even playing the trailer for House of a Thousand Corpses, the movie, in line as guests waited. But the house ended up having its name changed to Rob Zombie's American Nightmare after the film was shelved until 2003. So this year, House of a Thousand Corpses will return to Hollywood for technically the third time, as well as appearing at Orlando, so it is another shared IP. I cannot wait for this house. If you've watched any of my previous videos, you'll know that I am a huge Rob Zombie fan. So this year basically is my perfect year. So the description on the Halloween Horror Nights website says that this fall we'll learn firsthand why this house was built on horror. We'll come face to face with the psychotic Firefly family and their collection of blood and gore. Watch the legend of Dr. Satan come to life right before your eyes, and keep a lookout for Captain Spaulding's newest addition to his Museum of Monsters and Madmen, Fish Boy. And if you're lucky, you'll escape the house as fast as a rabbit, minus the fluffy bunny costume and tragic ending. Honestly, everything about this film will work so well as a house. Obviously because it was a house first. But some things that I'm super hoping to see in this house are Captain Spaulding's Museum of Monsters and Mad Men. Obviously that was already highlighted in the blog post. I'm really hoping that it features the scent of fried chicken. In a dream world, I'd love it if we could experience the murder ride as a true to the film ride experience. I know that that's very, very unlikely, and the more likely scenario is that we'll walk through the murder ride section of the house, but that will still be incredible to see. It already highlighted that we'll see Fish Boy. I think that'll be super cool. I want to see the Who's Your Daddy scene. Amazing. Slim Whitman's I'll Remember You playing in the barn scene. Cannot wait. I am so ready to see Otis in his ceremonial outfit out in the field scene with all of the cross-marked graves. He is one of my all-time favourite horror characters. I absolutely love him. But the part that I'm looking forward to the most is the underground tunnel scenes. I think they're going to be scary as remember how scary the tunnel section of the Poltergeist house was last year, where you were walking like below the pool, below the house, and then you went up into it? That, but times that by 10, it's going to be terrifying. I'm ready to see the walls lined with skeletons and a chandelier made from bones. I think it's going to look incredible. And of course, Dr. Satan in his super creepy underground lab, his creations, and his giant minion at the end of the film. I think that this house is going to be ridiculously scary. I know that there's been quite a few people talking about how this year seems as if it's a little bit toned down. I think that this has proved everybody wrong. Also announced this week was our second show, which is Halloween Marathon of Mayhem. So this is going to be a Lagoon show, and we spoke a little bit about this in the previous video where it hadn't been announced yet, but we'd kind of assumed that's what it was going to be based off of the popularity of Cinematic Celebration. So the announcement blog says, watch as the Lagoon transforms with a spectacle of neon and synth, featuring iconic scenes from top horror films, cult classics, and TV shows. Grab a bucket of popcorn and get ready as Lagoon lights up with iconic scenes from Stranger Things, Ghostbusters, Universal Monsters, and Killer Clowns from Outer Space. This new show features a blend of fountain-based media, state-of-the-art technologies, and special effects in a new way. This is one 80s nightmare that you won't want to miss. So the show times for each night are going to be 10 p.m, 11 p.m, and 12 a.m. I can't wait to see this show. I think the last time that I saw a show on the Lagoon at Halloween Horror Nights was at Halloween Horror Nights Suite 16, and I think that people are really going to love this. We also heard that Terror Trivia is back, so we can test our Halloween Horror Nights knowledge and compete for a space on the leaderboard with 11 horror-packed levels. It'll feature questions on this year's event as well as Halloween Horror Nights history, and we can unlock achievements along the way. I am excited to get myself on that leaderboard. So moving on to my Halloween Horror Nights 29 hype list. What I'm going to do is just list them all real quick, and then if you guys want to hear more about my thoughts on the houses, you can go back and watch all of my previous house announcement videos. I'll make a playlist so it's really easy to find them. It was really hard to make this hype list this year because I'm very excited about all of the houses and I think they're all going to be amazing. It's a very, very strong year for houses this year. However, I have to rank them. So number 10 is Depths of Fear. At number 9, I have Us. At number 8, I have Nightingale's Blood Pit. And then this is where it got extra hard to make the list. So at number 7, I have Killer Clowns from Outer Space. At number 6, I have Ghostbusters. At number 5, I have Yeti Terror of the Yukon. At number 4, I have Graveyard Games. At number 3, I have Stranger Things. And 2 and 1 were extra hard for me to decide on, and I think that I switched them both around about 10 times before I started recording. But number 2 is going to be Classic Monsters. I'm very, very, very excited for this house. Obviously, I love me some Classic Monsters. I'm incredibly happy that it's going to be a house this year, and honestly, number 2 and number 1 are joint number 1 for me. So that means that number 1 is House of 1000 Corpses. I already recorded my Scare Zone hype list in the previous video along with the Scare Zone announcements. So if you haven't already, you can go back and check that out. I'll post the link in one of these corners. But I want to know your hype list, so let me know in the comments below. We are less than 3 weeks away from opening night to Halloween Horror Nights, and I am getting so excited about my trip. If we're not already friends on Twitter or Instagram, you can follow me here. And I'll be posting loads of content while I'm away. If you feel like getting yourself in the Halloween Horror Nights mood, you can go back and watch my vlogs from previous years. Again, I'll post a link in one of the corners and on the end slide of the video. But that is it for this video, and that's it for Halloween Horror Nights 29 announcement season. I will see you guys at Horror Nights. I'm gonna blow everyone's mind with some dope history. Did you know you can't make a noise in my video? We'll come face to face with the Firefly family. Why? Firefly, 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 Firefly. We'll come. This is why I drink before I record videos. We'll come face to face with the psychotic Firefly family. Am I saying family? Am I saying family? Firefly, Firefly.
Fire.
The family. You can't do English. We'll come face to face with the Firefly. We'll come face to face with the psychotic Firefly family and their collection of blood and gore. My God.